Muhammad Dompas.
Hey, come on over, guys. Have a seat.
The guys
sit right here.
Hi. How are you? Good. Thank you. How are you? Oh, my God.
So,
surprise.
What a jazzy way to start our Sunday morning. Welcome back to the C Morning Show. As you can see, that was Muhammad Dompas with Laughter Master. Wow, great performance, guys.
Of course. Thank you so much. So, you guys are known each other from, you know, from, I don't
know
from
any.
Exactly. Now you guys are collaborating. Is this your first collaboration? No?
As a duo project, yeah.
Yeah, as a duo project. Yeah. This is our first.
Okay. As we know that Nikki is one of the greatest musicians, guitarist. I think he's very talented. We know him since, I don't know, I watch his performances since probably around 2008 or 7.
Okay. Wow, it's a while ago. So we have Nikita Dompas collaborating with Rafi Muhammad, and both of you are, I would say, at the top of your game for your instruments. Like, I mean, when you talk about drum collaborations, I've seen you feature with many musicians. Mm-hmm. And both of you now together started this project. Whose idea was it? I mean, you guys have known each other for a long time, but whose idea was actually to create this Muhammad Dompas?
I think it came from Rafi's idea.
Because I just released my EP, and it's only a four song. And I know Nikita also have three songs. Yeah, we can do collaborate.
This is very
organic.
Much like the
because they know each other.
What about the album art? I'm curious. Whose idea was that? The side by side.
Oh, is in the toilet.
That must have been Rafi. No, that was your idea.
No, it's his idea.
Oh, really?
It was mine.
Very cool, though. By the way.
And you probably noticed Rafi, right? Mm-hmm. He was a magic kid. You know, who played drums, very talented as well.
Yes.
And I've been featured on his
video clip.
Exactly.
My music clip,
back
like
then.
10 years
so
ago.
Fun. Exactly. Now you guys are collaborating with Muhammad Dompas. So it's a collaboration between a highly skilled drummer, guitarist, was also an award-winning music producer. So please tell us more about the music that you guys are, you know, creating.
Muhammad Dompas rooted in jazz.
Okay.
But yeah, we have a similar influence, yeah.
Okay.
So the thing is, like, we both grew up with jazz, but we like to dancing.
So it's jazz like with a twist.
Yeah, it's jazz with a twist. We call it in Indonesian as jazz tapi party.
Itu penting banget, jazz tapi party. Jadi orang bisa enjoy sama musik.
That's right, indeed. So, tell me about Laughter Master. Laughter Master.
It's Ravi's music.
Okay.
Yeah, the song is dedicated for people with the good sense of humor.
Okay.
That's the story behind the song. Okay.
Because you guys like to have fun as well, right?
Yes, of course.
Definitely. So, in regards to your concepts, who is the one that takes the lead to create, like, this is what we're going to do? Is it a collaborative brainstorm? Do you guys just come out with ideas? And who usually is the one that makes the decision?
It's basically, we put everything on the table. Mm-hmm. And we decide what type of music that we want to play,
okay,
and how we play it, and who's going to play, and all of the songs, mm-hmm. who's you know, in terms of musicians, who's going to play the bass.
Right.
Well, actually, we're going to play in the next festival next week. It's not just the two of us.
We have
a bass player who's.
Well, you have a fantastic bassist right there.
Yeah, Dompas is the bass player, and we have. A friend of ours, Rian, he's actually in charge of doing the electronics. And all types of electronics. Yes. And another saxophone player, but especially, he specialized in playing the baritone saxophone. It's not the original, you know, it's not the common saxophone things that, you know, instrument that you see. The baritone one is like long and produce a low, more
bassy, I guess. Bassy, heavy.
Heavier tone.
Yeah. Right, that's so cool.
Wow, so very technical. Because, okay.
You know who's going to be the busiest? The all-electronic
exactly.
guy.
Yeah.
Everything electronic.
Yes. And you guys are going to perform with the Jaffa Jaffa.
Yeah.
Yes, that's
all.
Yeah. That's
cool.
Right.
Let's talk about that
all
a little
the team.
Bit.
Yeah. Exactly.
So was this put together for specifically for that as well?
You can say that, because it's probably going to be our
debut.
Yeah, that's going to be our debut.
So you haven't performed together in this format yet.
Yeah, no, not yet.
Wow. Oh, what a debut, Java Jazz.
So basically the music, your music, Nikki and Rafi as well, inspired, you know, many or are influenced by any particular musician or probably where you get the inspiration?
From anywhere. So the thing is, we grew up with jazz, but we listen to any kind of music.
Okay,
why don't we name a few of the top on your playlist right now? If you were to take out your phone, who would you have?
Robert Glasper, I mean, Robert Glasper, Foo Fighters. Oh. So random, but yeah.
Very cool.
That's me.
Listen to a lot of Glasper as well, and then Jay Dilla.
Ooh. And a bit rockish stuff,
some, you know, rock music, like anything.
So
I love slow jams as well.
You cover a lot of genres. So how would we describe your genre? Because you say it's jazz with like
party,
added twist, right? But this is actually going to be performed. You guys are going to be performing a Java Jazz
with
this formation with many other talented musicians as well. So what can we expect from this performance at Java Jazz?
Oh wow.
We guarantee you guys dancing.
You know, just put on your dancing shoes.
What day are you guys performing?
Friday.
On Friday, so that's
the first day.
Yeah. Which space is it?
It's in an outdoor stage in 11 p.m.
Okay.
So it's a very good timing.
Party time.
11 p.m. Amazing.
It's the time to be dancing at Java Jazz, right? At 11 p.m.
On Friday, then. Is there any collaborator, like a vocalist? Because since you guys are only musicians, you're only playing the instruments, right?
Not yet.
Okay. Are those ideas being thrown around? Like, hey, if we have a vocalist featuring, who would it be? Have you thought that far yet?
We haven't thought about that, to be honest. But, you know, it's always a possibility.
Mm.
in the near future, probably. Yeah.
So it's not going to be a temporary project.
No, I hope not.
That's interesting.
Yeah, because you know, Java Jazz is the perfect time for you not to have a vocalist.
Yeah. Like
that's the time, right? That's the time you can get away with
people
like a full set
of right.
appearance.
Right.
That'd be so cool, right?
Right, right. So, how is the preparation to debut on Java Jazz Festival? Since you know, people are excited to come to the festival
and it's coming soon.
And to see you guys performing as well.
We just did our first rehearsal. A week ago. It's very productive. I think we covered 4 or 5 songs and 3 hours time of rehearsing. Oh. And you know, it's here and there.
Yeah.
It's basically going to the direction that we want.
Yeah. This is what we say in Bahasa. We always say this is a jam terbang.
Jam terbang.
These guys are so experienced that it doesn't matter. We can just practice a couple weeks before the main event. So. Let's talk about a little bit about. I mean, you have both been involved in performances, Java Jazz, and things of that sort. But Java Jazz itself has changed over the years. In fact, I would like you to tell me what your perspective is on the jazz scene right now in Indonesia, because it has evolved, it has changed. Like performing acts like yours probably wouldn't be as easily accepted like 10, 15 years ago.
Yeah, the thing is amazing. Indonesian jazz future is amazing. Like, it's many prodigies now.
Yeah.
Yes.
Oh, is that right?
Yes.
Young musicians.
You have a lot of talented musicians, you know, over the years, especially after the social media era, where you can actually see a lot of potential musicians, not just from Jakarta, but from different
Indonesia,
parts of
Indonesia.
Right.
Yeah.
And in terms of the jazz scene, or I think it's, you know, it's easy now to come and see different performances of different types of jazz. And you have, you know, you have bars, you have clubs, you have jazz, you have actually like independent jam sessions going on somewhere in Jakarta.
The scene is there now.
It's
like it wasn't really there before, right?
Yes, it's definitely evolving.
Yeah.
Yeah. It's a bright future.
Very cool.
Wow.
You guys were the young musicians
exactly.
of the, you know,
very...
10 years ago.
Yes.
And now you guys are becoming the, we call it senior.
Established.
Nikita is senior.
You're not yet.
That's interesting part. Uh-huh. Nikita and Rafi are collaborating and they make Muhammad Dompas
as a
whole team, as a musician. How do you guys collaborating? I mean, in a music perspective, you have your own perspective. Also, Nikita, how you combine it, how is the brainstorming process?
She wants to ask, do you guys fight?
No, we never.
Really?
We're sweet.
No, I think, as I said earlier, that you said jam terbang, or I think like the 10,000 hours.
Yeah.
And so we plan things ahead. So we did all the, you know, we did all the concepting part.
Okay.
You know, we brainstorm a lot just before we went to the studio.
Oh,
So whenever we come to the rehearsal space, then we know what are we expecting.
Okay.
We already prepared it.
Yeah, we prepared it. You know, we spoke every day. We speak, you know, we're doing, we chat about this type of music that we're going to play, how we're going to play it,
right,
and who's going to, you know, in terms of choosing the member of the band, just going
the
back and forth, like, okay, the additionals, like, should we play with this, or do you want to play with this?
Okay.
So you're more productive, so by the time you get to the studio, you're not flying blind.
He is so wise.
Yeah. So, Java Jazz is the big performance, but following that, where does Muhammad Dompas go after this? Are you guys releasing more of a full-length album that features all of your collaborations together? What's next?
We'll see. I think we wanted to play in more festivals, more gigs.
Yeah. Yeah.
So we get, you know, we get the 10,000 hours as the Muhammad Dompas. Yes.
Right.
Wow.
So, and then
like, so people are more familiar with you guys as a duo as well, right?
As a unit. Yeah. So it's not as an individual.
I can imagine they're on a jazz club and people see every, I don't know, each particular day, yeah. see they're performing, you know, definitely. Like the old days.
Yeah, I'm okay. fun, right? really looking forward for that.
Ooh, okay, guys.
So that's going to be, what's the first day? Is going to be June
2nd. June 2nd.
2nd until 4th. Oh,
that's coming up.
And you guys
soon.
Are going to play on the first day, 11 p.m. Yes. on the outdoor stage.
Yeah.
Ah, okay. For how long the performance?
An hour?
Ooh. 1 hour set.
An hour set.
Just in time.
You're going
just
to be spoiled the by the good tunes by them.
That's right. Well, by the way, you guys going to give us another performance?
Yeah.
Yay!
All right. So, Mohammed Dompas, we'll let you get back there and get ready.
Best of luck,
while
guys.
We wrap things up.
Thank you.
So
right.
Thank you guys for coming by.
To have you guys in the studio.
What is the name of the song that you're going to perform?
Little Steps.
Little Steps.
Any meaning behind it?
Oh, I wrote that when, you know, I think I wrote that 10 years ago when when my daughter's learned to walk.
Oh, that's so cool. Okay,
and now
so
she's taking
personal.
Big steps.
Yeah, it's a personal story.
All right, go ahead. And as you prepare for your performance,
thank
again,
you.
Amazing.
When was the last time you went? Did you go to Jabba Jai since the pandemic?
The last time, I think a year before the pandemic.
Okay, so before the pandemic,
yeah.
that's for sure. But last year, I had a lot of friends that went. Mm-mm. That's such an amazing experience mm-hmm. because it's back fully for the first time.
Yeah.
But if you remember last year, they still had the rules of you had to wear masks indoors.
And have to get the, you know, like the test.
That's right, you have to get a positive test result. That's right.
Yeah.
But everybody enjoyed the outdoor area because you didn't have to wear masks.
Exactly.
Now, Mohammed Dompas will be performing in
that's
the outdoor
good
area.
Idea. Oh my God, they're so clever.
Exactly. So they got the right spot at the right time.
Yes.
So anyway, I believe they are ready. So here to perform their other single just for you on the C Morning Show. Please welcome back once again Mohammed Dompas with Little Steps.